as far as the house is going, then that'd be great, because that finished off. I'd like to come back feeling nice and relaxed and looking pretty good, and give me some ideas on how I can dress up for my charity ball tomorrow.
At the house, it's time for me, Kevin and Stuart to get our heads together and devise a plan of action.
Oh, boys, boys, what are we going to do?
I don't know.
What do you think these are?
Boxes.
Yep, and what are we going to do first?
I'm in dire need
of some help upstairs, yeah. Believe me. That room is so cluttered, I'm going to... A little help will not go amiss, guys.
That's all right.
Upstairs, I'm going to concentrate on an inner sanctum for Angela upstairs. Nice, calm, relaxed... Place to think, place to sleep, and place to dream.
Excellent. And I want to carry on that kind of caring thing. So in the dining room, I'd like to have like lots of indulgent things, like nice coffees and chocolates and nice sort of packages, and maybe use some nice china or something.
Lovely. All the fun, don't
you? Yeah, the room upstairs, or the spare room, I just think it needs, it could do with redefinition. It's not happening for me as a study. Right. I think it needs to be a bedroom.
Do you think just not redefinition, just definition? I don't think it's ever had any definition.
That is very true, very true.
And we've got a little bit of a girly theme. Eclectic selection of pinks.
Ooh, that's unlike you. Yeah.
Feminine side coming pinks, out. Yeah.
Look, matches my pants.
Before we do anything, we need to get change. Yeah, come on.
And so after the quickest of changes, it's packing boxes at the ready as we start to tackle 6 years' worth of clutter. Angela's got a lot of stuff and we've got to be careful we don't throw anything precious away. But Angela's mum, Madge, has stayed behind to assist us in our efforts and ensure that things are properly taken care of.
Fortunately for us, Angela's already made a start in this room, but as she's so busy, she's just run out of time, and hopefully we can finish it off to her satisfaction. Now, I've already removed the carpet. She's got some new carpet here ready for us, which is very handy, and I've popped down this gripper rod. Now, when you're actually going to fit these gripper rods, ideally what you do is cut them using the secateur, which I find is a lot more effective than sawing. Also, when you're actually screwing or nailing down the gripper rod, you've got to leave a slight gap down the side here. And this is an order for the carpet to be fixed into. Now, what you can do, if you just put the grip rod on the side like that, that ensures that you've got an even gap the whole way along when you're actually nailing it down.
Angela leads a very hectic life with all her charity work. So what I want in this room is for her to come back, relax and chill out. I've used these mid-tone colours, and they create a feeling of calm. The darker one is going against the back wall, which will make the room much larger, and that we've got this lighter tone round the rest of the room, which will create a feeling of light, airy space.
Angela's arrived at her destination for a makeover at a top-class city centre salon. She's got an important charity ball tomorrow night, and so she wants to be looking her best.
Simon, can I take your jacket for you?
OK, fine, thank you.
Is it Angela?
Yes, please.
Hi, I'm Simon, I'm colouring your hair for you today. OK, sort of follow me through.
Thank you.
Right, what can I do for you today?
I don't know. Surprise me.
Any ideas?
No.
Do you prefer, like, the highlights to be quite fine, or...?
I'm happy with whatever you fancy doing, to be honest.
Getting the colour right takes an experienced hand, and whilst top stylist Simon gets to work, our own colour specialist is busy back at Angela's house.
Just doing the cutting in the bedroom, this is a cracking colour that Kevin's chosen. I think he's really come up trumps. The lilac's going to be beautiful in here. I think it's going to be much better than this wallpaper. Now, talking of wallpaper, when you're actually going to be painting over the top of it, even if you do get a once-cover paint like we've done here, it's not really going to do the job just to do one coat. You're really going to need to do two in order just to cover up all the patterns. Also, try and remember that if there's any pieces of wallpaper that are peeling off, make sure that you stick those down before you commence your painting. Steph, what you got going on down there? You're working hard. Got Madge hard at it.
We're sitting down, but we are working hard, aren't we, Madge?
We're working very hard, yes.
We're just clearing all out this room. She's very busy, Angela, isn't she? She's very involved in a lot of different activities.
She's too involved in many things, I'm afraid. But she also tries to give back something to Multiple Sclerosis Charity, which she has gained quite a bit from as well.
Because she has multiple sclerosis, doesn't she?
Yes, unfortunately.
And does she find that actually it makes it difficult for her to tackle housework?
She gets very tired very easily.
So housework-wise and design-wise, do you think it would help her to have very nice, clear surfaces?
Well, I think so, because I think you can clean a house in a very short time if it's clear of clutter.
Do you know, I keep saying that on this programme. Would you like my job?
And whilst there's still plenty of Angela's belongings to be packed away, Stu and Kev make light work of redecorating the two upstairs bedrooms.
I've left Madge upstairs clearing all that clutter. I don't envy her. And Stuart's been busy here laying this new carpet. A big, big improvement on that brown pattern carpet we had this morning. And it's a really lovely colour and ties in beautifully with this china.
And if you've got precious china hiding behind glass at home, get it out and give it a clean. Dust can be abrasive and wiping it away can easily scratch surfaces. Best use a soft, dry cloth or brush. It may say dishwasher proof, but it's wise to wash your best crockery by hand in warm water with a gentle detergent. Avoid harsh chemicals, scouring pads and steel wool. They'll do more harm than good. Best leave your pots to drip dry on a rack, but you can mop up excess water with a soft, clean tea towel.
Well, that's the last bit of dust. Seems like a cleaner's work's never done. Now, we've created this luxury food hamper for Angela because we thought she deserves a treat. It's a really simple and stylish idea that doesn't cost very much for your dining room. And not only does it look great, it also releases a beautiful aroma throughout the room. Is everything all right up there, lads?
Yeah, it's all right. Kev's just dropped the bed. Come on, Kev, you big butch Scotsman, you. Put your back into it.
I've never seen so much rubbish.
All right. Watch my paintwork.
That is... I know it seems a bit bizarre to be bringing other bits of furniture in when we haven't cleared this out, but literally we have no space, so massive big storage units like that we're going to have to keep. Probably the white units are the best because they're crisper and cleaner.
Yeah, I think you're right.
The problem is, it is literally we're battling against loads and loads of stuff.
Yeah.
So it's just technically... What?
I don't know where you're going. You've got to help me get all this out.
No, I'm going to have a cup of tea first. And I'm coming back.
There's still a long way to go in the guest room, but we've already opened up a huge space. At the salon, Angela's restyle is well underway. She's feeling more relaxed, but is worried Mum Madge might be too keen on the clearing back at home.
Do you trust your mum with your house?
Do I trust my mum with my house?
Yeah.
I will probably go back to find there's not an awful lot left. I've trusted as far as colour goes and choice of everything else, but it's the kind of stuff that she's going to chuck away and get rid of. That's slightly worrying.
After a short stint under an impressive hands-free hairdryer, Angela is ready for the next stage.
Okay, that's ready to be washed off now. So if you want to follow me over to the basin.
Angela's not the sort of girl who has the time for three-hour hair appointments, but we felt with her busy lifestyle she deserved a little time out. Who wouldn't love to spend the day being pampered? But is she glad her mum set her up today?
Ooh, I'm sure she had my best interests at heart. Well, I know she did, because she always does, so... And it helps her as well, because she hasn't got to finish up with the jobs off or nag me much more, so... No, I'm not really cross with her.
Angela, you'd be proud of the way she's working.
Madge, just a question I have to ask you. What was she like as a kid? Was she a hoarder?
Yes, she was a hoarder. And she had a bedroom which was cluttered.
And what about the spare bedroom? You know, the one that was
the
full,
front bedroom.
Rammed full, the front bedroom, yeah.
The rubbish room, really, I suppose, yeah. Where everything went. Mm.
Well, there's more room now. They can get in there now that we've moved all the cuddly toys out.
Cuddly toys, which in my view should have long ago gone to the children's home.
I actually agree with you.
Well, I've taken down the old curtain track, and luckily it was mounted on this piece of timber batten, so this has meant I've not actually had to drill a hole through the wall and plug it. I've just had to simply screw straight through this piece of batten, which is very fortunate indeed. Then, what I've got to do is mount the rest of the fixings, because Kevin's got a beautiful voile that he wants to attach to this. Now, this is going to give this room a bit more of a magical, dreamy kind of a feel. But unfortunately, whilst the voiles are beautiful, they're not entirely practical because they let the light in. So what I've also done as well is I've put this lovely blind in, which colours, I think, complement the other colours on the wall perfectly. And that way it's going to be more practical and it's going to stop the light coming in.
At the salon, Angela's hair is nearly finished, but is she happy with the results?
It's going to take some getting used to. It's been a while since you've been this short, but great job. Love the colour.
And to go with a new haircut, Angela's next appointment is with a top beautician, where she hopes to pick up some top makeup tips she can put into practice before her charity ball.
Hi Angela, how are you? All right. I'm fine. I'm Louise, nice to meet you. Ooh, champagne for you. Come and take a seat by the mirror.
I've had the hair cut and coloured, so really what I need now is a new makeup to go with the cut and the colour, so that tomorrow night when I go out on our charity ball I will feel happy and comfortable and be able to reproduce it myself. So I suppose that's what I'm looking for, a new makeup to go with the new cut and colour.
As beautician Louise gets to work with the foundation, Angela can watch every move she makes in a handheld mirror. What better way to learn the tricks of the trade? So is she as relaxed as she looks?
I'm feeling pretty shattered, but I'm enjoying the day. I'm intrigued as to what's going on at home, but I'm sure it'll be fine.
So just a few final finishing touches to the makeup and Angela's ready for the ball.
How do you feel about that?
Yeah.
Like it?
Mm-hmm.
Success. Angela's gone from this to this to this, and all in a few short hours.
Now I've got the new hair, the new makeup. So I've got to look forward to the new house.
Well, I'm back in the bedroom again. This time I'm actually cleaning the headboard for Angela. You'll remember at the beginning of the day I explained that the dust from the environment and the grease from your hair and skin actually can make the headboard very dirty. And in this case, as it's fabric, it actually settles deep within the pile. So what I'm using is an upholstery shampoo, and I've tested it for colour fastness already, and I know it's all right to use, and a standard old nail brush, which is ideal for the job. Now, you just use the bubbles from the shampoo, so it's actually quite dry, and then rub it on and it will give it a deep, thorough clean.
The great thing about painting flat colours in this room is that now we can punch up a bit of graphic art. I've chosen these pebbles, which are kind of reminiscent of relaxing on a beach, and I think they're going to add to the quiet, still, relaxed atmosphere of this room.
And there are many other ways in which you can create a relaxed feel in the bedroom. Turn the main light off and use table lamps to create a softer ambience. Candles are well known for their comforting aesthetic appeal, but try scented candles for a double dose of relaxation. Turn the radio off, unplug the telephone, then try a little soothing music. You'll be blissed out in no time. Angela is on her way home, but has she enjoyed her day?
The day's been great. Been looked after really well. Been pampered and preened and feeling really good. I'm feeling a little, no, not worried, but I'm looking forward to going back to what they've done. I think I'm going to be amazed. Bit of trepidation, but I'm sure they've done a great job as mum's there making sure that they're not going to do anything I don't like. Well, I hope the house is behaving badly experience will just give me that spurt to make sure that the house doesn't get into quite such a mess again. And that'll keep it nice and decluttered.
The work at the house is nearly done. All that remains are a few finishing touches in each room before I can send Stuart and Kevin on their way.
Well, it was fast and furious.
It was good fun though, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good fun.
I'm really pleased with it today. I think we've done really well.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm particularly pleased with Angela's bedroom. I mean, I think we've really achieved what we set out, all of us together.
Yeah. It's beautiful, you know, actually. And it's a nice, the boils and
calm, relaxing space that, you know, she can come back, de-stress and, you know, have a nice time.
Yeah. Definitely, yeah. I think I might move in.
In the spare bedroom, I mean, I could not believe the state of it when I walked
it was
in.
A
I mean, and the amount of boxes that we had.
I know.
It was unbelievable.
All in all, I mean, I think we've done a really good job.
Great. Yeah. And your work's finished now, so you
it
can
is.
Go. Farewell, my friends.
See you later.
See ya.
When we first saw the dining room, it was obvious Angela had run out of steam with the decorating and hadn't got round to replacing the carpet. So we finished off the wallpapering, laid the carpet and rearranged the furniture to make better use of the available space. The guest room was another matter. There was 6 years' worth of clutter piled from floor to ceiling. So we cleared everything out, reinstated the bed and brightened the room with sugar-sweet candy colours. Angela's bedroom did look a bit like a toy shop, and the combination of yellow and blue was hardly the most restful. So we took out the toys, painted the walls with neutral colours, dressed the bed luxuriously and dimmed the lights.
Come in, come in, come in. How was your makeover? Was it lovely?
Right, lovely.
Yes.
Really pleased.
Oh, was it really lovely being pampered?
Yes, it was.
I did think of you many times today and thought, I wish I could swap places. Did you think of us?
Oh, yes.
And how do you feel now?
Slightly nervous, but looking forward to it. I'm sure it'll be great.
Excellent. Come on then, let's go and have a look.
This is how the dining room looked when Angela last saw it. She left the room in this unfinished state, but is she going to approve of the changes we've made?
It's my room. It's my carpet. It's my display cabinet with the lights on. It's brilliant.
You like it? What we've done in here is we've finished it off. You obviously have made a start, but we appreciate that you do so much and, you know, difficult for you to find the time. So we've finished it off, keeping in keeping with what you were hoping for, I hope, anyway, and laid your carpet. A big improvement. And
it's
we've moved it around because the piano, actually, because it's the darkest piece of furniture and the boldest, it kind of needs to sit on that wall design-wise. And this is where Kevin is excellent, and he's got that kind of knowledge.
He's got the knack.
And then your lovely china is brilliant colour to match in with the room. And we've given it a clean and redressed it. So I don't know if it's rejigged a little bit from how it was this morning, but
just
it's all there.
Great.
Are you pleased with it?
Yeah, really pleased, yeah.
Excellent. Well, there's more.
My guess is that Angela won't recognise her guest room at all. With so much clutter in the room, it was hard enough finding space for your feet, let alone for a bed.
Well... There's floor.
There's carpet. When was the last time the room was cleared out like this and sort of had the character of a room?
The day we moved in.
Which, how long have you been
Nearly
here?
Nearly 6 years.
Nearly 6 years, my goodness. So what we've done is we've built this into your guest room now, because obviously you've got a lot more space in here than in the other little room on the side.
Yeah.
And we've painted it's like quite a fun room, quite girly, because the idea is also use it as your dressing room.
Yeah.
So it's like an extension to your bedroom as well.
Great.
So you can come in here and try things on and look in the mirror and get yourself dressed in the morning. Does it get the thumbs up?
I think so.
Excellent. Right, well, there's one more.
Angela's bedroom didn't look much like the oasis of calm she needs with such a busy lifestyle. So have we achieved the perfect stress-free zone for her?
All right, are you ready?
Yes.
Oh, I'm so excited about showing this to you. Go on, have a look.
I can't. Eek! My bedroom. Oh, wow. God, it's incredible.
What we've done is we've made it sumptuous, because I kind of the word that describes it. It's very touchy-feely. There's lots of textures, the cushions on the bed, the throw. The walls are very neutral and nice neutral tone, a very cool and calming, a place for you to come and relax. So it's a kind of a grown-up version. Your bedroom is very functional as it was before.
Was like that.
And this is kind of stylish. And of course, we've redressed the windows. Yeah. We know you're a light sleeper and you had your curtains to block out the light. But the idea with the blind, obviously, is that you can shut out the light with that. Mm-hmm. And if you want to be here in the day and have some light, but a bit diffuse, a little bit more romantic, you can shut your walls. Now, you'd need to make me a bit of a pledge that you're not going to reclutter it.
I shall certainly do my best.
Very good. That's good enough for me.
If you're lacking the time and energy for housework, here are Houses Behaving Badly's three golden rules to ease your workload. Devise a cleaning regime to suit your needs. A little light dusting once a week is enough to keep the dirt at bay. Don't let the clutter get on top of you. The longer you leave it, the worse it will get. Use neutral colours and soft lights to make your bedroom a haven of calm at the end of a busy day. 2 weeks later, we paid a return visit to see how Angela was getting on with her restyled rooms.
Hello, come on in.
Angela has rearranged the furniture, but the dining room was still tidy, with plenty of space to move around in.
The dining room is handy because it is a dining room, so it's nice to be able to use it as a dining room rather than sitting and having trays on your lap. But also, it's such a nice, pleasant room now because it looks out on the back garden that I actually take my cross stitch in there and sit quite happily in nice daylight and do a bit of cross stitching because it is just so nice and relaxing.
We'd made big changes to the guest room, but Angela's charity work means it is once again doubling as an office.
Well, the fact that Mum's been in and helped start clear some of it out has actually given me the impetus, because really before, I'd walk into the room and not know exactly where. I'd think, I really ought to start clearing this, but I didn't know where to start. Well, now some of the stuff has gone. There's still a lot more that I need to clear, but at least it's given me the impetus now to actually get it sorted so I can get that room into a usable state so it can be used temporarily. The computer's in there. There's a single bed in there. So somebody could stay there once I've got it cleared. Since you came, my bedroom feels so much more relaxing with the clutter gone. It's one of the things they say with feng shui and all this kind of thing, that you really don't want a cluttered room where you want to relax and to sleep. And it does feel an awful lot better. And I have actually kept it that way, which I think Mum was quite surprised about. It was so nice to get rid of the blue and yellow. I must admit, for the last few months, I've been looking at it thinking, oh, I really must.
Basically have lots of fingertips coming and opening and closing, and you can see this makes them grubby, not just on the front, which you can see, but down the side and also on the inside. Talking about on the inside, have a look in here. I mean, it's really grubby in here, so really make sure that this receives good attention as well. Make sure once a month you clean everything out and wipe out your cupboards.
I'm just painting one of the last stencils on the wall. What I've done is I've got some bits of cardboard and I've created these lovely stencils of spotlights. They're kind of studio-style spotlights. And we've painted them on the wall in black. And what we've done is use light beams of different colour going across the wall to give it this very, very dramatic kind of feel to the room.
But how's Helen feeling on her visit to Bath? Well, as every woman knows, the very best way to start a special day out is with an indulgent pampering session.
Feels lovely.
Foundation first.
Oh yes, that is a great improvement. Yes, I like that. I think she'd better move in with me.
What, another person?
But what about lipstick colour?
Not pink, no pink. I don't do pink.
But in the end, Helen's persuaded indeed to plump for the pink.
Yes, very, very happy indeed.
It seems that Helen's enjoying being pampered, but what does she think Robert is doing at home?
Acting under instruction, I hope. out of the two of us, he's the one that tidies. I've always been a muddler.
And how does she think the team will be getting on?
Panicking at the state of Duncan's bedroom, perhaps? gobsmacked at the state of my kitchen?
But at least Helen's getting away from it all. Final treat, perfume.
Oh, that's a lovely whiff.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
Back in Bristol, we're still busy pampering Helen's house.
A lot of kitchens have these corner cupboards, which, when they're fitted with a carousel, provide really useful storage space. However, in Helen's kitchen, she hasn't got a carousel. And obviously, we have to make the best of what we've got. But the access is really tight. I don't know if you can see this. I mean, it literally just barely takes you standing up without even bending over and looking for something. And where Helen's gone wrong is, have a look over here. She's got all of her essential foods in here. She's got her family beans and soup and stuff. And it's a cupboard of which she actually needs a lot of access. So we're just going to give her a little bit of a reorganisation, and what we'll do is, in this cupboard here, you can see there's all the old baking things. We'll give the cupboard a clean out, and we're actually going to use this cupboard in here for food storage and pop these baking things, which she won't need so often, in this corner cupboard, and hopefully make her life a bit easier.
It's a very straightforward task, but reaps results, as does applying a little elbow grease on cleaning that grimy bath upstairs. It's hard to believe it's the same tub.
The kettle is a piece of kitchen equipment that receives really high usage. I mean, how many times in a day would you make a cup of tea? But whilst we often enjoy what comes out, we forget what happens inside. And this kettle here is a really good example. It's absolutely clogged with lime scale. Now, I've got a great tip to help you get rid of this lime scale, and it just involves simple brown vinegar. So all you need to do is just fill your kettle up with hot water and put in a third of the quantity of water that you've got there of brown vinegar. Just simply dribble it in,
and leave to soak for at least 1 hour.
Then you want to rinse out your kettle, fill it with just normal water, boil it again, and hey presto, the lime scale should be cleared. Now, in order to maintain it that way, a really great idea is to get an oyster shell. I know it's really unusual, and you want to boil it in water to make sure it's absolutely clean. And then you pop it in your kettle, and it just stays in there. And what it does is it attracts all the lime scale from the water to the oyster shell and makes your kettle element remain nice and clear.
A pearl of an idea, but there's still work to do to get this kitchen shipshape. It's time for Danny to banish those tatty carpet tiles and lay new lino.
We're lucky enough to have a brand new lino on the floor, but sometimes you can get little scratches or little holes, and I've got a great tip for remedying those sort of problems. Get one of these from one of your kiddies, a normal crayon, and hopefully you can get one that matches the same colour as the lino. And what you do is whack a little bit of this on the microwave and warm it for a few seconds. And when it's soft enough, you can apply it to the hole or to the scratch, wipe it over smoothly so it's level, and then that should fit in just nicely.
Unfortunately, wax crayons can sometimes be used less effectively. Here's our guide to removing unwanted artwork from walls and floors. Crayon is resistant to water, so pre-soak the stain with isopropyl alcohol, which is available from pharmacists. Leave to stand, rub with a scrubbing brush, then rinse with water. Felt tip, cover with hairspray and wipe clean. Ink, cover with toothpaste, leave for 30 minutes and wipe away. Paint, sorry, the only option is to paint right over it. Over in beautiful Bath, Helen and Lizzie are painting the town red. With its Roman roots and historical architecture, Bath is one of Britain's top 10 tourist attractions. But all this sightseeing must be positively exhausting for our ladies, so it's off to Bath's famous pump rooms for a spot of light lunch. And after lunch, one must sample the renowned and restorative Bath waters.
Basically what it is, the spring water of Bath, it's a geothermal warm spring water coming from at least a mile down.
But what does it actually taste like? Lizzie's not too impressed. What about Helen?
By golly, it does you good.
That's the spirit, and it seems that Helen has made a new friend.
She's terrible.
Absolutely. Okay.
All in all, a very successful trip. And back at the house, we're having a very successful day too.
Do you remember earlier in the bathroom, there wasn't even a lid on the toilet seat? Obviously, it's really important to have a lid to keep all those germs in and keep your bathroom hygienic. The other important thing to remember is the bathroom's actually used by every member of the family. So it's important to set some rules so everybody helps keep the bathroom in check. The first one I would recommend is to get a nice soft cloth. And after you've used the bath or shower, give the sink area or the bath area a nice rub down. Don't forget the taps either. And the reason this is a good idea is it's going to stop any of those water drops drying and leaving hard water ring marks around, which looks really untidy and makes your bathroom look dirty and increases your housework. So that's a really great tip.
Remember, bathrooms are havens for pet hates. Our top three pet hates are as follows. Top of the list, not replacing the loo roll, followed closely by leaving globs of toothpaste in the sink, and last but by no means least, water blobs on the mirrors.
And don't forget the towels. Don't leave them in a scrumpled up heap like that on the floor. They look really untidy. Make sure you put them in a nice place, tidy place, either over the radiator or on the towel rail, and leave them to dry. Remember, leave the bathroom as you'd like to find it.
But the question is, will Duncan like the changes he finds in his bedroom? Sam and Danny have worked wonders to make the most of his tiny box room, and this mirror surrounded by fairy lights will help create the illusion of more space by bouncing light around the room.
Structurally, the house is really good. Aesthetically, it needs a bit of TLC, shall we say.
And we've certainly lavished plenty of TLC on this house today. The theatrical theme is really coming together in Duncan's room, and a few finishing flourishes in the other rooms will ensure that this house is destined for the big time. Sam and Danny, on the other hand, are destined for a well-earned rest.
I think the day has gone tremendously well. But I think the one room where the transformation is absolutely amazing is just Duncan's bedroom, and he's just going to go into orbit when he sees that.
But after a fun-filled day in Bath, is Helen going to be equally over the moon with our endeavours?
How was your day?
Absolutely wonderful.
Excellent.
We've laughed, we've eaten, we've laughed, we've drunk, we've shopped, we've laughed. It's been fantastic.
Well, it sounds like you've had a great time. What have you got in your bag?
I have here some of the makeup that was used when I had a makeover this morning.
What a treat.
And there's more treats in store. Is Helen ready to tread the boards in her new kitchen? This morning, every surface was teeming with clutter, crumbs and chaos. The once white units were greasy and grimy, and the carpet tiles had certainly seen better days. Now every door, tile and appliance has been scrubbed, and this kitchen has been treated to a front row seat and has a positively glittering future ahead of it.
Come on in. That's fantastic! Oh, just look at the floor! And you've mended my own! Oh, it's wonderful! It's wonderful!
Lila, oh, you're all right. Oh, don't get upset. You won't be able to see it all.
Oh, it's absolutely fantastic!
So what we've done is we've just toned it down a little bit because it was obviously very, very blue, and the blue made it quite dark in here. So we've brightened it up with a bit of cream, and we've really tried to pull both sides of the kitchen in together.
Yes.
So instead of having a kitchen and a storage area, you've got sort of a whole big kitchen to use now.
Oh, it's absolutely wonderful. It's fantastic. I'm lost for words.
Oh, and what about the blinds? Come and have a look over here. See, we've tied in both of your windows together, giving you some really nice jazzy blue blinds.
Oh, they're lovely. Oh, that's
just taking it all in.
It's just so different. It's just...
It looks really great inside. We've had a really good clean of all the fronts of your cupboards and everything, and cleaned out your oven for you.
I'm lost for words. I am just totally lost for words.
Well, let's go and have a look at the rest and hope you find some words before we go into the next room. Come on.
The kitchen's a hit, but is the bathroom also a star in the making? When we arrived, the peeling paint and slimy soap scum ensured that this room would never be topping the bill, but a thorough clean and some show-stopping accessories mean that it's now sure to be top of the A-list.
It's a different room! So you've put a loose... You've put a lid on the loo! Oh, that's fantastic! It's wonderful!
So what we've done is we've just calmed it down a little bit. We've used this lovely peach colour which opens the room out and makes it feel a bit bigger.
Yes.
And then followed your example of your wooden accessory with your mirror and your toilet roll holder with the blind and the new toilet seats you spotted. Clean the bath.
Wow, I couldn't do that.
And tied in all the black accessories, the black tiles, there's really nice smart black towels there. And this is the pièce de résistance. Look at this, is the absolute film stars.
Yes.
Shower curtain. Everybody that your little boys will aspire to, hopefully.
Yes.
And more.
But today's Academy Award for the best performance must go to Duncan's bedroom. Earlier today, it wasn't even picked for a nomination. But it's made a clean sweep. Plucked from obscurity, no one could now accuse this dramatic room of being amateur.
Oh, he'll love it.
a performing arena, didn't
yeah,
oh, we?
Absolutely.
He's such a star.
Oh, yes. We've
got some spotlights, some dressing room lights.
Oh.
The whole film feel, and this lovely centrepiece here with all the pictures on of him to display them to the full.
Oh, it's beautiful.
Oh, it's wonderful.
Oh, I'm off.
Oh, my. Oh, my. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. It's fun. Oh.
Well, you see, you've got your own spotlights. You've got your own dressing room mirror.
I know. It's, oh, my God. Oh, my God.
And have you seen your film strip on the
yeah,
wall?
I know.
With all those fantastic
pieces. This is the best.
If, like Helen, you don't want your domestic drama to become a crisis, here are our rules of the day. Keep your kitchen clutter-free. It will be much easier to keep clean. Don't neglect odd jobs, particularly where hygiene is concerned. Encourage your children to look after and respect their own space. But as time goes by, will Helen be able to pull off a performance worthy of a standing ovation?
Hi, nice to see you. Come on in.
First up, let's see if Helen's managed to keep that kitchen spotless.
I've got more of a desire to spend time in it. I've even been known to get the sweeping brush out and clean it, which is very rare for me.
A very promising start. But what about the bathroom?
Now, I clean the bath, whereas before, I might give it a cursory wipe round. I'm fussier with the children about leaving clothes littered around. I do try to get them to clear up at bath time. It doesn't always work, but I live in hope. And I spend a lot longer in the bath than I did before.
So it seems Helen's doing a fine job. Can the same be said for young Duncan?
Well, the day that they came, when they opened the door, I honestly did think it was a dream. And every day I come home now and I just think, is it still going to be there? I feel happier every time I just go into my room and go to sleep and I wake up in the morning. I just feel so much happier. I do try a lot more to keep it tidy.
There's just one thing left to say. Bravo!
I do hope that I will be able to keep up with the keeping things clean and keeping it tidy. We've also thrown away at least 2 black bin bags full of clobber, rubbish. To say that we are pleased that houses behaving badly came here is very, very much an understatement.